Okay, so we successfully authenticated using OAuth authentication, and now we are ready to call REST API get method, retrieve data, and then paginate through the results. And actually, we already have the data after testing our OAuth connection. So we got context, has more, and some kind of with offset column. And all the contacts are put in one row. And to fix that, we will have to go to properties, filter, select filter, and select the data we want. And we want contacts, right? So I'm selecting this contacts array. Going back to preview, hitting preview, and voila, we have more rows. Okay, so now we are ready to paginate through the results. And to do that, let's get back to documentation, the same page which talks about getting all the contacts. The first thing we need to do is to find a parameter which lets configure the maximum number of contacts we get in one request. So we are trying here to minimize the number of requests, and we see that the optional parameter count actually does that. Let's use specify the amount of contacts to return. So as you see in at least in this page and in many other API providers, the method will have the parameters, and there are three type of parameters you might see in the documentation. It's header parameter, then there is URL parameter, as it says here, and then there is body parameters. So you should enter them and configure accordingly. So we see here the required parameter OAuth access token, and actually if you took a look here, we are not passing anything, but since we have OAuth connection manager under the hood, when the request is being made, it adds a header, and exactly this kind of header, authorization bearer, and adds the token. So this parameter is taken care of, and you should always pass all the required parameters, otherwise the request won't succeed. And when you have URL as a parameter, URL parameter, you should go to URL, and if it's the first parameter, you just enter question mark and then enter the parameter and its value. If it's second parameter, use ampersand and then use some kind of parameter again. So I'm wiping these, and now we have 100, now we will have 100 contacts returned for us. Okay, so the next thing is pagination. So let's configure pagination, and you should look how to paginate in the documentation as well. So usually there is some kind of section about pagination as a generic article which suits for all the methods, all the requests, or maybe it's present and it's written something about in the same article. So if I scroll here, I would see that this very weird column name we had with offset should be used as a next as a parameter to get the next page. So this with offset is actually a reference to the next contact in the next page. So I will select this pagination now option, select this option 2, and select the next link or cursor expression. And now I'm selecting this with offset property. So what it does, basically it retrieves this with offset value and saves it in the next link holder, placeholder. So now what I have to do is I have to modify our URL slightly and add another parameter and use this placeholder which holds the value to the next contact in the page. Actually, if this with offset, some APIs return and the property with full URL to the next page, so I would just have to use it like this. If with offset was an URL, but it's not, so I'm pasting in here. Now I have stop indicator attribute, and you remember from our results there was this has more. So basically it talked about if it's the last page or not. So I'm saying if it's the last page and the value is false, like in this example, has more is false, then it means it's the last page and I want it to stop. Okay, let's get back to preview. Let's make a preview. And we're kind of having the same results, but basically it will paginate. But the problem I see now is that I don't see any emails, and I have again get back to the documentation and see where are those emails hidden. So again, I can go back here in the documentation and look in the sample response and find it that email is actually under identities property. Or I could use a more fancy way and get this Fiddler tool, which is a web debugging tool and lets you to see what other programs doing. By that I mean what HTTP requests they are making. So be sure to have this option capture HTTPS and decrypt HTTPS traffic options checked, because almost every request will be made to an API will be secure. Okay, so let's make this preview. As you see, we are requesting for a new token, and here is the response. Okay, a bit slow. Okay, so in this part you see the request, and in this part you see the response, and here is the sample JSON return. Not the sample, I mean the actual contacts, but it's not very nice to view. So I will press this JSON tab, go to contacts, and we'll try to look for email. Identity profiles, identities, and I see that when the type is equal to email, I will get my email. So now I will do the same thing here. So I will use a selector and I will select my emails, identities, and I will select identities here. The problem is here that it will select also Yeah, let's make a preview and you will see the problem again. Is that it also returns lead get, which we don't need. So let's modify this this JSON path query. And what I will do is I will write this expression that when in the identity the type is equal email, I want those records retrieved. Basically, I want only those. So I'm escaping single quote with double quote. Now previewing data again. And now only emails are present. You can read more about JSON path when you press this what's this link. You will see examples and yeah, different JSON paths, etc. It's very simple, like an XPath. So if you are acquainted with that, it will be much easier for you to understand. Okay, so we are now ready to use this query in the Excel. Okay, so I'm pressing data from other sources from Microsoft Query, selecting the data source I created, selecting any table with any columns because I will be using a query. And here I am saying that I want to use the query. Okay, clicking the SQL button to open this window, clicking paste, clicking OK. Okay. Closing, getting back Fiddler. Sorry, so that you could see how it works, how the pagination works basically. And you see the pagination already started, and it simply adds the vid offset to the next link, and it increases 100 at a time. So you see this request, let's say it has this vid offset as a response, like 10,853, and it is used in the next request. Okay, so we retrieved the data. Let's look to the right. Yeah, I will hide these columns, hide these, hide, and I got my contacts, all 1000 and something. Okay, so this ends data retrieval and pagination part, and in the next part we will cover the topic of how queries work and how to build them and use them in applications.